Friends, we are going to show you video of 3-in-1 multifunctional rework system MFRS500 sold by INDE Enterprises. This is very useful for reworking SMD and PTH components, and it can operate all three tools simultaneously. Rework system also features an inbuilt vacuum pickup, and vacuum pickup can be extracted by rotating this knob, and rubber insert pad should be fixed on top of this vacuum inlet. Vacuum can be activated by pressing the vacuum button on the front panel. This feature can also be used for pick and place the SMD IC. For deactivating the vacuum, we will again press the vacuum button and the SMD. Now we will remove a large size SMD IC with the help of a preheat plate, and on top of it we will flow hot air. See, we have affixed this PCB in the adjustable PCB holder, and we will also place a thermometer close to this SMD IC to measure its actual temperature. We will switch the unit on, and we will move the hot air iron downwards and just place it on top of the IC. See, the hot air is flowing from the upward direction, and from bottom heating preheat plate is generating the heat, and hot air is flowing. And we will see when the thermocouple is measuring the temperature of IC, when it will achieve 250 degrees Celsius temperature or more, then we will activate the vacuum and lift the IC. Now see, the SMD IC has been removed successfully and without damaging any track. We will move to the through-hole desoldering part. In this step, we will explain how to desolder the through-hole components. We will first apply some flux on the pin to be desoldered. Then we will pick the desoldering iron and place the nozzle on the pin to be desoldered. We will keep it here for few seconds, then we will rotate it and then activate the vacuum button. We will see that first pin is desoldered, then we will move to next pin. Same procedure will be followed. Now we will see the last pin is desoldered and the component we are desoldering is taken out. Now we will move to the maintenance part of desoldering iron. The solder is collected inside this solder collection tube. First we will pull this trigger down and take this solder collection tube out. We'll show you where the solder is collected. Yeah, solder is collected inside this spring. We need to clean this spring regularly, and then after cleaning we'll again place it back and keep this solder collection tube on the desoldering iron. Pull it back and then again press this back portion to lock it again. Few spares are also provided along with the desoldering iron. These spares can be used when the older one are to be replaced. Now we will show you how to clean the desoldering nozzle. Choose the cleaning pin according to internal diameter of the desoldering nozzle and just insert it inside the nozzle and pull it back. We will move to the next step and show you the function of soldering iron. We will solder a small chip component with the help of soldering iron. First we will apply some flux on the part to be soldered. Then we will place the SMD component and align it. Yeah, now the component is aligned along with the track of PCB, and one track is being soldered. See, the leads are being soldered one by one, and we have successfully soldered this small chip component to the PCB. Okay. Now we will show you how to change the soldering tip in hot condition. A silicon pad is provided along with the soldering iron to change the tip in hot condition. Simply we need to pull the soldering tip and insert the other soldering tip by pushing it inwards. Now we will explain the calibration feature of this Rework system. We will measure the tip temperature of soldering iron with the help of external calibrator. We will apply some solder wire and then we will measure the tip temperature. Now the set temperature is 350 degree, but the value observed on the thermometer is 367. We will input the value observed on the thermometer into this unit. We will first press tool 1, then we simultaneously press and hold temperature up and down temperature button. The unit will enter into calibration mode. We will input the value we have observed on the thermometer, that is 367, and then press the vacuum button. Now the value, the offset value given to the unit is accepted, and we will then verify the temperature once again. The set and actual temperature is almost same, and the soldering iron has been calibrated. Thanks for watching this video. Bye.